Hey guys, today I'm going to be playing with the Lego Technic Excavator set number 42121. And yeah, before we start, I'm going to tell you something. So on our channel we don't just do Lego building videos, we do Connects building videos, beyblade videos. We also have another channel called Parsatube Gaming. We do gaming videos such as Minecraft, Cotton Rubber, Roblox, Bloons, City Battles, Grow Empire of Rome, Among Us, Stick War Legacy 3, and Bloons TD Battles 2. So let's start. So here is the instruction booklet. And if you remember from where I unboxed this thing, it was a 2-in-1 set. So soon I'm going to be building the other one, which is I'm not too sure what it is, but yeah. Here is the first page of the instruction. And if we go and yeah, so now I didn't get everything from this set, but here it is. If you don't actually have this set, all I'm gonna say is it's a really good set, and it's got two really cool features. Well, to me it's like three, but I don't really count this as a feature. And one of them is of course lowering it down, the arm down, not the whole thing down, and up. It's up and down. It's only this bit that actually moves. Then here we have the, so if you don't know what's like pushing it up and down, it's these pistons over here. If you look at this piston, as you can see, it's moving and moving, yeah, until it doesn't go all the way. If you can see, if you go all the way, it'll just make this noise. Look, it'll make that noise, but don't do it. And also, as you can see here, you might be thinking, well, why am I not using this? Well, if you look, as I move this bit, it actually moves. Just look at that bit over here. As you can see, it's getting more of an angle. If I do this, it's getting less of an angle until it's completely straight. And yeah. So as you can see, if I move it, and the third feature, well, it's not really a feature, spinning it around. I'm not too sure if it counts as a feature, but to me it is. And here is the where it goes up and down, up and down. And on the side, we have this where it goes open and shut. And here we got the actual cockpit, and you can also take it off. It's really simple. I'm just gonna go here, see this, you can just take it off. So it's for the person who sits here. It's actually also not supposed to come off. It's actually supposed to come off so you can put the minifigure inside. But there's also another way. So you take this off, and then this will come off as well. So yeah. I was just pushing it too hard, but yeah. Anyway, moving on. The only reason why I move it and the chains don't always move is because I got a very smooth table. But here I'm gonna show you. And yeah. But first I'm gonna, before I actually show you how to scoop it, and I tried before the video, it's so hard to do it. You need the immense skills. As you can see, it moves on the couch. And if I go in this crease over here, the little gap, as you can see, it like goes down. And see, it also like, it's like really cool. And I guess I haven't actually tried scooping it on the couch. Maybe it's better than on the table. So yeah, let's lower it down. Let's open the arm a bit more like that. Let's lower it. And then we'll just go back. Oh, it doesn't work like that. I'm gonna go a bit up. Then I'm gonna try and scoop one up. Yeah, that didn't work. Maybe because it's all... I'll just do that. If this doesn't work, I'm gonna be sad. Yeah. Yes, finally! I've actually tried so many times before. One is my new high score. It's like those claw machines in the arcade games. They're so hard to grab. Like, it's nearly impossible to get anything out of them. Yeah, anyway, I'm not going to spend the rest of the day just getting all of these up. That would be taking a very long time. Anyway. So, if you didn't see my unboxing video, go and check it out. And also, yeah, here it is. So yeah, let's just do this. So, hope you guys like it. Subscribe to see my videos. Bye, bye guys.